Continuing now from the state capitol in Hartford, meet the leaders and our guest now, a bit of a silver anniversary, we're going to call it, because this is State Representative John Piscopo's 25th legislative session. He is in 13 terms, 25 years as a member of the State House of Representatives. Congratulations.
Well, thank you, Jeff. 25.
That's a milestone. Now, are you the longest serving in the House? Almost, aren't you?
Almost. Not, okay. Yeah, on my side, Art O'Neill 1 year ahead of me.
Okay.
And Mary Mashinsky and Pat Dillon on the other side of the aisle. I came here with Bob Godfrey from Danbury.
Well, happy 25th.
Well, thank you, Jeff.
Now, representing
Appreciate
the fine
it.
Town of Thomaston, Harwinton, Northfield, and Burlington, I believe.
Yes.
Okay. Well, let's talk about the budget. Of course, it passed along party lines. The Republicans called this a budget of gimmickry. The Democrats said it was a very responsible budget that keeps things where they need to be so the state can progress. Your take on the budget to start with.
Well, in the beginning, at 1 o'clock in the morning on Sunday morning, it's not a good time to take out the budget. It should be done in the light of day. And that's my first objection to it. It raids a lot of funds. It raids a special transportation fund. It raids a conservation load management fund. That's a fund for renewable energy that we had just passed it earlier Saturday. We doubled the fee on your electric bill that goes into the conservation load fund, and they raided it later on that day. So it raids a lot of funds, and there is a lot of gimmickry. It taxes that were due to sunset do not sunset. So I'm really disappointed. Plus, we're going to get the gross receipts tax on July 1st. Mm-hmm. I put an amendment in during the budget debate at about 2:30 in the morning to get rid of to not have that gross receipts tax increase that's statutorily due on July 1st, and that's going to hit. That's going to cost our people a lot more in gasoline now.
Okay. So they say no new taxes, but we're going to be paying more in gasoline.
Yes.
Okay. Well, let's talk another issue, if we could, money-wise, Representative Piscopo.
Sure.
And that is the minimum wage. It's been a few years since we've seen a rise in the minimum wage. It's now $8.25 an hour. January 14, it goes, I believe, to $8.75. January of 15, it goes to $9 an hour. Where did you stand on that?
That was another one we did after midnight. And in this economy, it's just the wrong time to raise the minimum wage. If you're even inclined to, I'm not inclined to. I think the market works. I think that if you offer a good job, there will be a good pay to follow, and it's just wrong that we manipulate that.
The upside, obviously, those who are on the lower end of the pay scale, they're going to get a bit of a boost, make things easier for them to get through each week and month. On the other side of the issue, say it's bad for business, cost jobs, is that it?
Terribly bad for business. A lot of our union wages are geared to the minimum wage, so it's not just the low-income earners. A lot of union contracts are geared toward what the minimum wage is. So they automatically will get an increase based on what the minimum wage is. And plus, even those non-union, if you're seeing someone under you get a raise, you're gonna go to your boss and ask for a raise also. So it's just the wrong policy at the wrong time.
One other thing that you told me that you felt was a wrong policy this session, about two-thirds of the state in a survey was against the passage of giving driver's licenses to immigrants regardless of their legal status. Mm-hmm. That passed. That'll be happening as of January 2015. You voted against that.
Yes, I did. And that was another one we did after midnight. We stayed up all night actually arguing that, debating that. It was thrust upon us. There were some in our caucus that were willing to work, that were willing to listen to this and try and find a solution. I was not one of them. I was really dead set against it right from the beginning.
Why is that?
Well, because it's illegal. They're in this country illegally. I think we have to address that problem first. The federal government's wrestling with this issue, and just to issue them a driver's license, I think was the wrong policy. It's going to set up Connecticut as a sanctuary state. So I really worry about that trend.
Okay. Well, one more day to go. Anything big coming down the pike in the last 24 hours?
Oh, there's a lot big. There's all the budget implementers. Those bills that we need to actually put the budget in effect. There's the bond package. There's a lot we have to do yet.
Well, as you keep burning the midnight oil before that final gavel comes down, I'm sure the coffee pots will be chugging away, won't they?
Oh, yes, they will. Yeah, it's been a lot of late nights this year.
Well, thank you, and again, happy 25th anniversary here at the State Capitol.
Well, thank you very much, Jeff. I appreciate your visit. Thank you very much.
You bet. Our guest has been John Piscopo, the Republican State Representative from Thomaston and environs. As we continue with our Meet the Leaders program here at the State Capitol, we have the 2013 session winding down. Back with another guest in just a moment.